Welcome to Physics Made Easy channel. Today we are going to start the second chapter of electronics, which is known as semiconductor devices. And in semiconductor devices, I will start with the PN junction. That's what is PN junction. So as the name is quite expressing, PN junction is basically when p-type crystal is brought in close contact with n-type crystal, then p-n junction is formed. How do we form p-n junction? P-n junction is on one side there is a p-type semiconductor, on the other there is n-type and there is some common area. So this is a very rough definition, but better to understand it in the initial stages. Now let us understand it, how it happens. Now, method one. Now what you do is, atoms of group 3 elements such as boron, indium or gallium, they are painted on one side of n-type silicon wafer, n-wafer. Acceptor atoms of group 3 elements such as boron may be painted on one side of n silicon wafer. For example, second method, boron atoms may diffuse into the silicon at high temperature. Since the acceptors take free electrons from N material, the surface wafer is made strongly P in nature. The density of the impurity atoms attenuates. I will straightway explain from the diagram. Now, here is, we have N-type semiconductor here. Negative charges they are representing. So this represents a position when we have time t is equal to 0, means we just attached them. They were just combined. On this side we have got n-type semiconductor. On this side we have got p-type. Or there can be an arrangement, as here it is written, on n-type silicon wafer, group 3 acceptor atoms are attached. Or some kind of diffusion has taken place. This is the time t is equal to 0. Beginning position, high concentration of holes on B side and very high concentration of electrons on N side. Now after some time, T1, what will happen? Some of the electrons will fill up these holes here. As a result, positive charge will develop on N side and negative charge will develop on P type. Now this charge is localized. This charge is localized due to attraction between these two. This charge is localized. This is positive donor ions. This is negative acceptor ions. Now, with the passage of time, this keeps on growing. And this become depletion region. We call it depletion region. Why? Because here we have abundance of free electrons in this region. And here we have got abundance of holes in this region. And this is the region in which we don't have abundance of free electrons or free holes. These are localized holes and these are localized electrons. So this region is depleted of free charges. That's why we call it depletion region. Now, this will form a capacitor as well. Negative charge is negative and positive charge plates. They are separated by some region. So capacitor will also be formed. Even you can say we will keep on discussing this in our next part. Hole is represented, for example, this is anode and this is cathode. Cathode is from where electrons are emitted. Now, this is the symbol, and this represents P, and this represents N. P, this is the symbol of P-N junction. This is anode, and this is cathode. Anode is where electrons are connected. Cathode is from where electrons are emitted. Now, in our next part, now how do we prepare this P-N junction? How do we prepare P-N junction? The first method is the diffusion of phosphorus into the P-type semiconductors at elevated temperature. Phosphorus diffusion of phosphorus. Second is the diffusion of phosphorus into one end and diffusion of boron into the other. In this case, we have got a semiconductor like this. On one side, here, we diffuse phosphorus. On other side here, we diffuse boron. As a result, whole part is created here and negative charge is created here, and this takes the form of n-type, and this takes the form of p-type. Here boron diffuses in this part and phosphorus in this. The wafer of P-N junction formed is cut into small pieces. Each piece is enclosed in a casing called electric connection coming out of P-N junctions. Now, unbiased P-N junction. Now, on this part, there is concentration gradient. Electrons, they are in abundance. And on this part, it is the hole which are in abundance. So there is concentration gradient. Wherever there is concentration gradient, diffusion takes place. Now, the first type of current, for example, we are representing this as a barrier. X1 and X2 are the two limits. On this kind, we have got acceptors. The concentration of acceptors is constant, and across here it falls like this, and on this side donors are in abundance. On N side donors are in abundance. This is the N side of the junction. This is the N side of the P-N junction. N side. And this is P side. This is P side. Here is the line X1, X2. From this side, it is the holes which diffuse, and from this side, it is the electrons which diffuse. Here we have got donors in abundance. Donors donate electrons. Donors donate electrons. On this side, we have got electrons in abundance. On this side, we have got holes in abundance. So, diffusion takes place from high concentration area to low concentration area. For example, concentration of holes is very high in this area. the holes will diffuse from this part to low concentration area. Now, concentration of electrons is very high on n side. Concentration of electrons is very high on n side, and electrons will diffuse from this side to this side. As soon as p-n junction is found, majority charge carrier begin to diffuse from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentrations. Thus, the electrons from the n region diffuse into the p region, where they combine to form holes and get neutralized. Now, in this portion, for example, on n side, what will be there? Now this is n side. On this n side we will have localized holes. On this side, we will have localized hole. On this side, we have got localized electrons. On this side, we have got localized electrons. Now, I will once again make you understand the difference between them. These red colors, they are fixed charges. They are not free. On P side, there are free holes, free conduction of holes. On N side, there is free conduction of electrons. But in this case, charge is there, but it is bounded. That's why we charge it, we talk it as depletion region. Now, the very first current, when you join n-type and p-type semiconductor, the current that flows is called basically diffusion current. Diffusion current. Diffusion current. I will call it as I diffusion. Or even we can call it as I1. Now, here this is positively charged plate you can consider, and this is negatively charged plate. So there is a potential difference. Whenever there is a potential difference applied to the charges, charges drift. We have studied drift current. In the section of electricity, we have studied drift current. Drift current flows under potential difference. And diffusion current, it flows under what you can call drift current flows under potential difference. Diffusion current flows under concentration gradient. So, electron hole recombination. Now, this fixed charges or bound charges are due to electron hole recombination. Now, current density JH. This is the formula for current density. This is the formula for current density. JH is equal to charge on electron into diffusion constant for holes into concentration gradient dP by dx. dH is diffusion constant, this is hole density gradient. Similarly, JE, this is the formula for current density of electrons. E into dE, dN by dx. depletion layer. When an electron diffuses N region to P region across the PN junction, it leaves behind ionized donor atom having positive charge, which is immobile. As I have used the word bounded, this is immobile as it is bounded to the surrounding atom. A diffusion of electrons continues from N region to P region. More positively charged donor atoms are created. So in this way, I have already described you this. So on this side, electron drifts towards this side and electron diffuse towards this side. This is very important to understand. This is very important to understand. Now, this is P side. You see, this is negative charge. This is negative charge. So you can say on this plate there is negative charge. On this plate there is positive charge. And current flows from positive to negative, conventional current. And electron drift in this direction and diffuse in this direction. Diffusion is due to concentration gradient. This is drift is due to potential difference. So electrons under the influence of potential difference drift in this direction. And under the influence of concentration gradient, diffuse in this direction. Similarly, hole, they diffuse in this direction and they drift in this direction, and this is a depletion region. This is the localized charge. And in this way, there are two kinds of current. One is diffusion current and other is drift current. Now, another important factor, as the diffusion current increases, drift current decreases. Now, with the passage of time, concentration gradient decreases. It means ID falls. A process takes place here. Let me explain it here because diagram is in front of us. With the passage of time, concentration gradient decreases. dP by dx or dN by dx. Both of them decreases with the passage of time. It means JE or JH. It also falls with the passage of time. But with the passage of time, more and more charges localize here. It means potential difference increases. It means drift current ID increases. So now what is there? As time passes, I drift goes on increasing and I diffusion, it goes on decreasing. At a particular stage, both of them become equal. Diffusion current becomes equal to drift current. Here, diffusion and drift current, they become equal. At this stage, as both of them are equal, equilibrium is established and depletion region reaches its maximum size and maximum potential difference. Depletion region or depletion layer in space charge on both sides of PN junction, which is immobile ion. This line is very important. bound charges on immobile ion. There are immobile ions which cannot move or devoid of any free charges. Electric field. There is positive space charge region on N side. Now, this is N side. So there is positive space charge region on N side and negative on this. Due to this, there is a potential difference delta V. And the length of this is also available. Let its name is X. Then E is delta V by X. So this is how electric field is exerted. An electric field is set up across the junction. Fictitious battery is established. For germanium, the electric field develops a potential barrier. Electric field develops a potential barrier and it opposes the further diffusion. And the value for germanium is this, and value for silicon is this. This is the value for germanium 0.3 and value for this is 0.7. This is also called knee voltage. Average potential difference is this 0.5. So average potential difference, I would like to say V average. V average is 0.5 volt. And now thickness delta X of potential difference, that it will be in microns, for example 10 is for minus 6 meter. Yes. The width of the barrier this is the width of the barrier. If I have to depict in this diagram, this is the width of the barrier. Or here shown. This is the width of the barrier and this is of the order of 10 raised to power minus 6 meters. So this is the width of the barrier. Now E is V by T. And this is 10 raised to power minus 6. Divided, no. V is of the order of 0.5 volt. V is of this order. So this is 0.5 and this is of the order of 10 raised to power minus 6. So electric field is very high. 5 into 10 raised to power 5 volt per meter. Note down the unit of electric field. Its value is very high. Now barrier width, I have just talked about. Barrier width, it is of the order of the physical distance between one side of the barrier to the other is known as width of the barrier. Its value is barrier height. The difference of potential from one side of the barrier to the other is known as barrier height, and this is the famous formula for barrier height, and this is the formula for barrier height. VB is potential barrier, T temperature, K Boltzmann constant, E electronic charge, N a number of acceptors, and ND number of donors. For example, this is N-type region, this is P-type region, and this is the potential barrier, and on this N donors and N acceptors. NT is the temperature, so this is the barrier, and NI, number density of intrinsic carriers, note this. NI is number density of intrinsic carrier, NA number of acceptors on P side, and Nd, number of donors on n side. Ni is intrinsic charge carrier, that is electron or holes. And with these words, I have finished this lecture, and very soon I will upload another lecture on this topic. And till then, before finishing this lecture, I will request all of you to kindly comment if you don't like this lecture, and share if you like. Thank you very much.